the Federal Polytechnic, the LARO, based on the arrangement, because this is a virtual ceremony, students are divided according to this breakdown. Here, in Rahim Oloyo International Conference Center, we have School of Environmental Studies. In the multipurpose hall, we have School of Pure and Applied Sciences, and then School of Communication and Information Technology. In Auditorium 1 and 2, we have School of Engineering HND in Auditorium 1, and we have School of Engineering ND in Auditorium 2. In 500 meters, we have School of Management Studies ND, while we have School of Management Studies HND in the Student Union, Christian Union Cathedral. I go over it again. Rahim Oloyo International Conference Center, School of Environmental Studies, Multi-Purpose Hall, School of Pure and Applied Sciences, School of Communication and Information Technology, AUD1, that is Auditorium 1, School of Engineering, HND. Auditorium 2, School of Engineering, ND. 500 meter, School of Management Studies, ND, and then Christian Union Cathedral, School of Management Studies, HND. Ordinarily, the procession ought to involve students, but because of the COVID-19 protocols, we are restricting the procession to the principal officers and members of the academic board, who, as the procession enters the hall, will stand up until they take their seat. Once again, you're welcome. My name is Shola Abiala, Deputy Registrar of Public Relations. Good morning. Your halls. But as soon as you see them on your screen there, you please stand and remain standing until they are seated. I wish to inform you that this program is being beamed live on poly.ilaro92.1fm and some of the social media. Thank you. national anthem. Polytechnic anthem. Round of applause. The rector, sir, principal officers of the Polytechnic, members of the academic board, distinguished guests, our great matriculants, once again you welcome to the 25th edition of the matriculation ceremony of the Federal Polytechnic in Aro. Today, ceremony is being conducted virtually in compliance with the COVID-19 protocols, which forbids large gathering of people. But the rector insisted that the matriculants should be accorded their due honor because that is the joy of being undergraduate. In this regard, I want to give the rector and the other members of the academic board and the management staff a big round of applause for this opportunity accorded every one of you. We have in the house the rector of the Polytechnic, architect Dr. Olusegun Olanrewaju Adigo. The rector, you're welcome, sir. The deputy rector, engineer Mrs. I.K. Ogunfayo. Deputy rector, ma'am, you're welcome. The registrar, Mrs. A.F. Oshore. Madam, you're welcome, ma'am. The porter, Mr. O.O. Ajibode. The acting Polytechnic Liberia, Mr. O.S. Babalola. We have the deans from this side, the Dean School of Environmental Studies, CPL. Lassisi. The Dean School of Communication and Information Technology, Dr. Mrs. C. Idoro. The other side, the Dean School of Engineering, Engineer Dr. Odunlami. The Dean School of Management Studies, Dr. Emi Akide. The Dean School of Pure and Applied Sciences, Dr. Mrs. R.C. Oyede. We have the directors here, the director, APP, Engineer Aikulola. The director, Resident, Engineer O.O. Oshore. The director, Linkages and Affiliation, and the immediate past director, Dr. Rahim Oloyo. The director, EDC, Dr. Esab Muhammad. The director, ACTU, World Bank, my money is gone. The director, World Bank, Barista Okuoga. The PA to the rector and deputy registrar referee, Mr. Femi Bankole. The director, Police Consult and Industrial Services, Mr. David Duruwaye. And the director, UNESCO and MBT UNESCO, RY Akibo. Sorry, the transmission is not getting clearly. We also have all HODs present. We have the deputy registrar, council affairs, the deputy registrar, the school, student affairs officer, and everybody. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, our dear matriculating students, you are welcome. My name is Shola Abiala, Deputy Registrar, Public Relations. Please join me in welcoming the Registrar of the Polytechnic to come over and take over the proceedings. Please put your hands together for the Registrar, this is A.F. Oshore, and to take over the proceedings of this world's gathering. The Registrar, ma'am.
Members of the academic board, academic and non-teacher staff, students, ladies and gentlemen, I have the greatest pleasure in inviting the rector to declare the matriculation ceremony for fresh students for 2020-2021 academic session open.
By the authority of the Academic Board of this perspective, I, Architect Dr. Ishefu Olarewaju, Director of the Federal Polytechnic in Aro, I hereby declare the matriculation ceremony for the 2020-2021 academic session open.
Director, principal officers, members of the academic board, academic and non-teaching staff, students, ladies and gentlemen, I have the greatest pleasure in inviting the rector to present his address. The rector, sir.
The principal officers of the Polytechnic, members of the academic board, deans and directors of service units, head of departments, chief lecturers, matriculating students, ladies and gentlemen. Gentlemen, welcome to all for this unique and noble occasion of the 25th matriculation ceremony of the Federal Polytechnic Laro for the 2020-2021 academic session. It is unique in the sense that This is the first post-COVID matriculation ceremony to be conducted by the institution. Again, this is the first time that the institution will be conducting a paid physic and virtual matriculation ceremony. It is this virtual to comply with the COVID-19 protocols, which forbid large gathering. At the same time, we do not want to deprive these young and vibrant youths of the joy associated with an induction to tertiary institution life called matriculation. Hence, this ceremony is holding from different venues, virtually linked together, thanks to technology. This ceremony marks the official enrollment of new students to the various schools in the polytechnic. It is statutory for us to formally admit qualified and deserving students, candidates, into our highly esteemed institution. We are optimistic that this event is a life-transforming one, and it is the beginning of the journey that should give your life a positive meaning, widen your academic and moral horizon, and open great doors of opportunities for those of you who, as a matter of conscious consultation, decide to choose to study in the best polytechnic in Nigeria. You should, in actual fact, consider yourself highly privileged to be one of the lucky candidates considered for admission out of thousands who apply for admission into this most sought-after polytechnic in Nigeria. Let me use the opportunity to make you understand that for the 2020-21 admission exercise, about 8,385 candidates sought admission into the Ivory Tower through JAMB for national diploma full time, out of which only 2,413 students were granted admission, which represents a pass rate of 39%. Likewise, the total number of 2,727 applicants or applications were received for the HND program, out of which 2,141 applicants were offered admission. So I want to advise you that you should reciprocate this gesture by showing greater commitment to that purpose for which you are admitted. It's a experience for you to understand that at the Federal Polytechnic now, we have a culture of excellence inviting landmark innovations. We are also effective and efficient in service delivery through the cooperation of both teaching and non-teaching staff of the institution. Our selling points. One of our selling points is our entrepreneurship education. The polytechnic is unique and it stands apart from all other forms of education. The polytechnic education, rather, is unique and it stands apart from all other forms of education simply because it places emphasis on skill acquisition, innovation, and self-employment. In fact, technological education without the know-how on self-employability does not work in pinch of salt. The Federal Polytechnic Bureau has long key to the federal government's right and passion to eradicating poverty and unemployment. We operate the Barrel and Resourceful Entrepreneurship Development Center, where students acquire skills in small business management in various trades, such as bottled water production, beads and wire works, venue decoration, cell phone repair, shoemaking, fashion designing, soap making, block molding, interlocking blocks, website design, computer repairs, aluminum works, catering, and bag making. It is compulsory for every student to pass through this center. You are therefore strongly advised to choose one of the vocational skills that are available and are of interest to you. We have had so many encouraging and hardworking testimonies from our former students who are self-employed and are doing so well locally and internationally. at the Entrepreneurship Development Center. Being admitted here is therefore a very unique opportunity to hand two certificates, having paid for one. The most exciting is the fact that the Polytechnic can boast of being the first and the only Polytechnic in Nigeria to have a driving school, certified and approved by the Federal Road Safety Corps and the Vehicle Inspectorate Division. This is aimed at ensuring that students, especially those in marketing and mechanical engineering department, who by virtue of their discipline are expected to know how to drive a vehicle. They will not only be trained on how to drive a vehicle, they will be equally be encouraged and assisted to apply for a driving license through the appropriate body. And I want to inform you, the driving school, the federal protection program, giving the authority to train drivers and give them the driving certificate, which enables them to get the driving license. So this opportunity is not limited to those two departments that we have mentioned, but as a priority, we give them preference because of the nature of their discipline. So any of you students that is interested in driving and getting a driving license should please enroll at the driving school. Guidance and counseling unit. The guidance and counseling unit of the Polytechnic is as old as the institution. It was established to assist individual students in the institution to understand, assess, and utilize their potential, abilities, attitudes, and interests to enhance their prospect of life. The unit was set up to prevent our students from losing confidence in themselves and their ability, and getting tense or introverted and emotionally disturbed. If you have any of these challenges, you are please advised to visit the guidance and counseling unit, which is spread across all the departments of the institution. The student handbook. The Federal Protection Bureau is known nationwide as an institution that encourages discipline among students and members of staff. As a result of this, students are guided by the various rules and regulations outlined in the student handbook, which have been provided for all our new students. You should therefore endeavor to study these rules and regulations and get used to them, as ignorance of any rule or law is not an excuse for any examiner or vice that are not in line with the rules and regulations of this institution. Discipline. The Federal Polytechnic Laro is known for its culture of excellence and discipline. We therefore have zero tolerance for any acts of discipline. According to the rules and regulations of our institution, the following are some of the acts of discipline we plan at seriously. Lifting of the campus, walking on the lawns, writing graffiti on walkways or debasing the walls of the Polytechnic, improper care for Polytechnic properties, cheating during examination, stealing, drug abuse, sexual immorality, disobeying lawful instructions, autism, skating, and other behaviors that are outlined in the handbook. The purpose is indecent dress, such as sagging, revealing clothes, colored hair, body hugs, face cap, or t-shirts with weird inscriptions, or driving of any institution vehicles without permission. All devices listed above and those that are not listed but are in their books are regarded as gross out of the discipline and are viewed with all seriousness. Please know that the discipline is not in our character as an institution. Grievance procedure. The management of the institution advocates consultation and dialogue as a veritable tool for peaceful coexistence. Therefore, students who felt aggrieved in any way must follow the right procedure by reporting to the appropriate quarters instead of resorting to violence. Let me assure you that this administration operates an open door policy in order to enshrine effective two-way communication. Sports. We are known for our active participation in sporting activities. The institution encourages sports and we reward excellence, both in cash and in kind. Therefore, there are so many sporting activities throughout the year during which the director and the management team are physically present to encourage the participants. Recently, we participated in the Nipusga, where the senior contingent, holding a lot of medals. The senior is one of the breeding grounds of sportsmen who have excelled and are excelling in sports, sporting activities all over the world. Student welfare. It is pertinent at this juncture to emphasize that we are committed to a responsive administration, and the welfare of both staff and students have always been paramount to us. In the area of medicals, our medical center is functional for 24 hours. The center now have made provision for laboratory tests, and the pharmacy is filled with relevant drugs. In addition, an ultra medical center is still under construction in order to bring medical care closer to our students. Electricity. Despite the fact that the power from the national grid is epileptic in nature, the polytechnic still provides more than 18 hours of electricity supply on a daily basis. Transportation. For ease of movement, our shuttle buses provide both intra and inter campus city transportation at affordable cost. During the exhibition, however, we provide free shuttle bus services for all locations within the town. Conclusively, we anticipate student needs and requirements and will map our strategies to meeting them before the student becomes activated. E-learning. The Polytechnic has for the past few sessions taken our students to another level by widening their horizon. Students in the various schools are mandated to undergo compulsory Cisco professional training in order to be versatile in computer literacy and prepare them for digital life after graduation. I'm happy to let you know that the majority of our students have appreciated this gesture by taking the training seriously. The beauty of the training is that its examinations and certifications are globally administered and monitored from outside the country to ensure that students who earn the international certificate from here truly underwent the required training. Library. The library has up to date facilities with electronic library services. This has made the Polytechnic Library to attract greater patronage and user friendly. Our e-learning library is one of the best that any student can get. We operate to satisfy our students. That means we work late, especially during the examination. Expectedly, all students must be fully committed to their studies in order to come out with flying colors. And this, I pray, will be your portion. Polytechnic through community relationships. Let me say emphatically that the institution has not been able to accommodate all our students on campus. Thus, majority of them stay on campus. Let me use this opportunity to call on all our students to always respect the culture, rules, regulations, and norms of those communities. You are therefore enjoined to strictly abide with these rules and regulations governing the community to avoid conflict or clashes. We expect you to live peaceably with others by seeing them as your brothers and sisters and mothers. By doing this, you will fully appreciate the culture of the community, as well as having a balanced intellectual development as good citizens. We are hereby admonished not to break the age-long good relationship which has been created and sustained over the years between the Polytechnic and our ever-hospitable host community. registered as teachers. For every hardworking student, there must be room for relaxation and fun. For this reason, the teacher encourages social interaction among the students. There are over 70 registered academic and social clubs with the Directorate of Student Affairs. These ones are also listed in your handbook, and we are encouraged to join those ones that are listed there and avoid any association with unregistered secret club, which attracts expulsion from the polytechnic. To our matriculating students, my dear matriculating students, the youthful age is the most interesting, vibrant, vigorous, versatile, and active period in one's life. It is the age of strength in which knowledge is acquired and experience gained. It is most importantly the age that prepares one for middle age activities. Little wonder it is battle at the prime or strength of life. This is because at this phase of human life, everything is working at the optimum level. It's at this stage of life that one is capable of doing so many things, either good or bad, that will either build or destroy the future. As students, you owe the society, especially Nigeria, our country, some responsibilities. As patriotic citizens, you are the leaders of both today and tomorrow. It is that time you stop the blame game and begin to take responsibility for your life. You should realize and accept that change begins with you. You are neither a biological mistake nor an accident of birth. Rather, like customized design of God to solve specific problems. No matter the challenges you may be facing now, please do not be tempted to take to drug addiction or trafficking, substance abuse, autism, stealing, armed robbery, examination malpractices, rape, prostitution, suicide, and other vices that neither have value to you or to the society. This is why the polytechnic, since inception, has not only continued to discover that glory lies in our effort of engaging in noble and academic and professional activities, but she's also striving to set standards for others to emulate. In line with this result, the polytechnic has, from the 2015-2016 academic session, gone fully digital in our admission and registration procedure. Equally, processing of student results and management of records have been integrated into the same platform. This presupposes that only today and fully registered students can have their record processed and actually students of this institution. Let me emphasize that you must ensure that you are fully registered as students. Not only pay your fees, make sure you are fully registered as students. Otherwise, God forbid, you might just be spectators instead of students of the institution. Remember, only registered students are considered as the different students of any institution. We take no responsibility for any unregistered student who parades the campus and even attend lectures as a student. We warn, whenever the bomb busts, you will be held responsible for your actions or inaction. Appreciation. Too much is given, much is expected. It will therefore not be out of place to appreciate our benefactors. My eternally grateful to the federal government of Nigeria for giving us funds for our capital projects and other activities. We are also grateful for the contribution of the Tertiary Education Trust Fund. Another funding policy program of this polytechnic. We are also grateful to the Governing Council, led by our Dr. Mrs. Veronica Ogwuagun, for our love. In fact, the chairman of the council, we go down in history as the first council arrived here with a volume of books as gifts for the first time in the institution. We are also grateful to all the individuals, our host community and corporate organizations who have in one way or the other contributed to the resounding success of this polytechnic, I say thank you. We appreciate and will continue to hold in high regard our landlord, the paramount ruler of Yewa land, and the owner of Ilaru, of our kind regarding what you will be assured and waiting for. For the donation of block of classroom and office to the polytechnic, and our distinguished senator, Olamide Kayayi, for facilitating the donation of a public library block to the polytechnic. To all other stakeholders, I wish to say thank you, and we promise to reciprocate your good gesture by trying to become better in everything we are presently good at doing, and the best in order to are better now, so that we can continue to be a positive reference point among the community of polytechnic. In conclusion, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, matriculating students, I want to once again sincerely thank you, especially my colleagues in the management, the academic board, and all academic staff, the in-house unions, staff and students who have been committed to the ideas, vision, and mission of this polytechnic, which have made us to have the kind of our colleagues that we now have. I say thank you all and God bless.
The academic board of the Federal Polytechnic Ilaru has resolved that the persons whose names are contained in the list to be presented by the deans of the various schools, having fulfilled all the requirements for registration, be now admitted as students of the Federal Polytechnic Ilaru. I therefore call upon the dean of school to present the candidates registered for admission into his or her school. Will all ND and HLD matriculating students in the School of Communication and Information Technology stand up and remain standing? All students in the School of Communication and Information Technology stand up and remain standing.
Yes, you are.
Ah, student. Well, I call on the dean, School of Communication and Information Technology.
In the name of the Federal Polytechnic Ilaru and by the authority of the Academic Board, I, Dr. Mrs. Charlotte Bosse Iroeduru, the Dean School of Communication and Information Technology, present to you the following candidates who have satisfactorily completed their registration for their programs in the School of Communication and Information Technology for admission as students of the Federal Polytechnic in Ilaru.
Will all the ND and HLD matriculating students in the School of Engineering stand up and remain standing? Students in the School of Engineering, stand up and remain standing. The Dean, School of Engineering.
Director, sir. In the name of the Federal Polytechnic Ilaru and by the authority of the Academic Board, I, Engineer Dr. Samson Abiodun Odunlami, present to you the following candidates who have satisfactorily completed their registration for their programs in the School of Engineering for admission as students of the Federal Polytechnic Ilaro.
Will all ND and HND matriculating students in the School of Environmental Studies stand up and remain standing? Students,
Director, sir. In the name of the Federal Polytechnic Ilaro and by the authority of the Academic Board, I, Kamplana Ademola Lukman Asisi, present to you the following candidates who have satisfactorily completed their registration for their program in the School of Environmental Studies, the Federal Polytechnic Ilaro, for admission to as students of the Federal Polytechnic Ilaro. Director, sir.
Will all the ND and HND matriculating students in the School of Management Studies stand up and remain standing? Students in the School of Management Studies, stand up and remain standing. I repeat, will all the ND and HND matriculating students in the School of Management Studies stand up and remain standing? The Dean, School of Management Studies.
In the name of the Federal Polytechnic Ilaro, and by the authority of the Academic Board, I, Dr. Akedemuka, FCA, present to you the following candidates who have satisfactorily completed their registration for their programs in the School of Management Study for admission as students of the Federal Polytechnic Ilaro. Director, sir.
Will all the ND and HND matriculating students in the School of Pure and Applied Sciences stand up and remain standing? I repeat, will all the ND and HND matriculating students in the School of Pure and Applied Sciences stand up and remain standing? Again, School of Pure and Applied Sciences. Director, sir, in the name of the Federal Polytechnic Ilaro, and by the authority of the Academic Board, I, Rashida Akinze, for your PhD, present to you the following candidates who have successfully completed their registration for their program in School of Pure and Applied Sciences for admission as students of Federal Polytechnic Ilaro. Director, sir. I hereby invite the Dean, Directorate of Student Affairs, to lead the students on notes. Will all students stand up and remain standing? All students, stand up and remain standing in all the schools, both ND and HND students. The Dean, Directorate of Student Affairs, to administer the notes.
I want all the matriculating students to say after me. After I, you put your names. I make oaths and state as follows. That I am a matriculated student. Registration number. That I hereby give and understand undertaking. To conduct myself in the most peaceful manner throughout the period of my academic pursuit in this station. That I hereby commit myself to governing student conduct and the Federal Polytechnic Ilaro. That I am also enjoined by the Governing Council of the Federal Polytechnic Ilaro, Ogun State. And I firmly agree by giving another ticket not to belong to, patronize, support, aid, or abet, or in any manner whatsoever be involved in any secret court or court activities or student association not registered and approved by the Polytechnic. That I will not in any way whatsoever attempt to interfere with approved academic calendar or any other decision of the academic board, governing council of the institution, that I shall not cross lines, feet during my stay in the Polytechnic, that I shall not in any way be involved in the handling of Polytechnic property without official permission, that I shall not in any way be involved in the driving of any Polytechnic vehicle under any condition, that I am fully aware that a breach of my undertaking herein may cause my photograph to be taken for record purpose and for other institutional uses. That I take this matriculation oath and reaffirm the same before the rector of Federal Polytechnic Ilaro, Ogun State, and undertake to abide by all stipulated rules and regulations of the institution. That I am fully aware that a breach of my undertaking herein will lead to my expulsion or suspension under the protecting regulations and get me handed over to the law enforcement agents where applicable for due process of the law to take in due course against me. That furthermore, in the event of my being found liable by the Polytechnic law enforcement agencies and or the courts for acts amounting to gross misconduct, which include undertaking 3 and 4 above, I shall accept my expulsion from the institution. That I am fully aware
And I accept that I can be tested for drug use if the need arises. That this matriculation oath has become necessary for my purpose of records, and that I make this oath most solemnly, believing the contents to be true in accordance with the oath of the law in force. So help me God. Congratulations. Now that you have made the oath, you are expected to make the oath to any high court for endorsement and report it to your respective school officer. Once again, congratulations. Sorry, don't take it to the court. Return it to us. We just fill it, then we complete the process. Once again, congratulations. Great Nigerian students.
The rector, sir, principal officers, members of the academic board, academic and non-teaching staff, students, ladies and gentlemen, I have the honor to invite the rector to formally admit the first student for 2020-2021 academic session now on loose into the various programs. The rector, sir.
I receive and admit you all as national and higher national diploma students in the various schools of the Federal Polytechnic in Arua.
I stand in front of for the management, the council, the heads of department, and other stakeholders to congratulate you for your admission into the Federal Polytechnic in Arua, the best in West Africa and the best in Africa. Principal officers, members of the academy board, staff and students, ladies and gentlemen, I have the honor to invite the Dean, Directorate of Student Affairs, to give the vote of thanks for 2020-2021 matriculation. The Dean, Directorate of Student Affairs.
On behalf of the Governing Council and the Polytechnic Management Chief of this great Citadel of Learning, I extend my hearty vote of thanks to every distinguished personality who has made this occasion a huge success in spite of the venom of COVID-19. Unfortunately, COVID-19 did not allow us to congregate at the usual matriculation ground with the parents and other special guests of honor. Yet we bless God for sparing our lives. We are grateful to all members of the academic board, ceremonies committee, technical crews, who rendered their expertise for the transmission of the events to all the matriculation centers and other social media to the delight of our dear parents and other well-wishers at home. Special appreciation for this coordinated effort by the director of CICT and media experts from the Department of Mass Communication. Our sincere thanks
go to the port of the Polytechnic Lare FM Radio 92.1, security operatives, all members of staff, union leaders, religious and community leaders, DSS staff, volunteers, cleaners, the entire student population, royal fathers and their parents, who could only watch the event from home. Finally, I want to appreciate our medical rector, Architect Dr. Olusegun Olarenwaju Alukko, and his team for this wonderful outing. And to the matriculants, the matriculated students, I leave you with the words of J.K. Rowling, the famous British author and screenwriter, who said, and I quote, "Achievable goals are the first step to self-improvement." I therefore urge you to work assiduously towards your goals. Remain focused and be disciplined, and you will be great. God bless our protecting community. God bless your land. God bless the state. God bless Nigeria. Thank you, one. Thank you all.
Officers, members of academic board, staff and students, ladies and gentlemen, I have the honor to invite the rector to formally declare the matriculation ceremony of the first student for 2020-2021 academic session. The rector, sir.
I now declare the matriculation for 2020-2021 academic session closed. The rector, the principal officers of the Polytechnic, members of the academic board, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, greatest Nigerian students, we realize that this is the first time I'm referring to you as students. Before, some few minutes ago, you were applicants. Now, you are students. Greatest Nigerian students. Our blessing to this announcement. After the recitation of the National Polytechnic Contest, the session will go out through the normal way. Students are expected to remain standing while the procession goes out, and no one is expected to move out before the procession, after which every other person will go. Academic board members and principal officers will be entertained at the boardroom of the Polytechnic. The rector, sir, shall we please rise? Meeting. Okay, there is going to be an academic board meeting immediately at the boardroom immediately after this ceremony. Director, sir, ladies and gentlemen, shall we please rise for the national anthem? Thank you.
Thank you very much. And the reception will be in reverse order. The last A will be the first out, that is to be led by the rector. Reception in reverse order. The rector, principal officers of the polytechnic, members of the academic board, distinguished staff of the polytechnic, greatest Nigerian students, this is the end of the matriculation of the fresh students for the 2020-2021 academic session being specially conducted today in five different venues of the Federal Polytechnic in Daro, the Rahim Oloyo International Conference Center, the Multi-Purpose Hall, the Christian Union Cathedral, Auditorium 1, Auditorium 2, and the 500-seater auditorium. As we said, this polytechnic is made up of four schools: School of Pure and Applied Sciences, School of Management Studies, School of Engineering, School of Environmental Studies, School of Communication and Information Technology. And we have so many departments there. Ladies and gentlemen, especially our distinguished students, you are now a bona fide and registered student of the Federal Polytechnic. Remember the content of the oath you have taken. Don't go against any of them. On behalf of the Governing Council, Federal Polytechnic in Daro, management, academic board of this institution, I, the Deputy Registrar for the Relations, Federal Polytechnic in Daro, Adiala Olusola, congratulate you and welcome you to the Federal Polytechnic in Daro. Appreciation goes to the operatives of the ICT, the Mass Communication Department, every other person involved in this unique and special location, we appreciate you. This is the first time that we are holding a virtual matriculation ceremony, which is live and free on all social media. Ladies and gentlemen, you are welcome. Thank you. God bless you. We'll meet next year. Thank you.